Okay, so let's begin with AVLSI lecture number 31.1. So the contents of this lecture will be based on 31.1 will be on the common mode response of a differential pair. So far we were talking about the differential signal or differential mode operation. Now we'll talk about and discuss about the common mode response. So first of all, what is a common mode response? What is a common mode input? So common mode input is denoted by V in of CM, and what it is the input applied to both the MOSFETs M1 and M2 gate terminals, which are equal in magnitude and equal in phase. So that means the same input you are applying to both the terminals. So that is what we call it as a common mode input. Fine. And we have the ISS current source, constant current source, right? So an important property of a differential amplifier is not only to increase the, amplify the difference between the differential signal, right? Different signals, but it also should have the ability to suppress the common mode variations or the common mode signal. Yeah. So this circuit over here, which we see in front of you, is a differential pair sensing a common mode input. And what have we done over here? In reality, the differential pair is not fully symmetric. Now, why it is not symmetric? Because sometimes this ideal current source is not available. In the form of this ideal tail current source, ISS, might exhibit a finite output impedance. So we have replaced this ISS with the RSS resistance. Okay, so your ISS is replaced by a very high output impedance. Okay, so as a result of this, what will happen is a fraction of the input common mode variation might appear at the output. So first we'll assume that the circuit is symmetric, that is RD1 is equal to RD2 is equal to RD, but the current source has a finite output impedance, that is RSS, shown over here, right? So let's say if the Vin of CM, that is the input common mode, increases, your node voltage VP will increase, but your output will fall down. Okay, as you can see, it is opposite. If the input common mode signal is increasing, your output is decreasing. We'll see that how. So increase in the input common mode voltage, that is Vin of CM, will cause VP to increase. Why? Why it will cause VP to increase? Anyone? If my common mode input voltage increases, why is my node voltage VP increasing? We have discussed this before. We have discussed this point before. Okay, now tell me, what is VGS? VGS is VG minus VS. What is VG1 equal to VG2? Vin of CM. And what is VS1 equal to VS2? VP. So when we say VGS increases, we ultimately say Vin of CM increases, your VP will automatically increase. Okay, so that's why we say that increase in input common mode level, a common mode voltage, causes the VP to increase and both VX and VY to drop. How? As your VGS1 and VGS2 increases, your ID1 and ID2 also will increase. And your VX, which is nothing but VDD minus IDRD, since ID is increasing, your VX and VY will decrease. So that's the meaning of the statement. Okay, so what do we do is, we'll assume that your differential pair is symmetric, and Vx remains equal to Vy. So when Vx remains equal to Vy, we can sort them together. So your X node and your Y node are sorted together. So when they are sorted together, these two transistors M1 and M2 will come in parallel. Because if you see carefully, the same input is applied to the gate terminal. Fine. And they are in parallel because your drain terminal are tied together and the source terminal are also tied together. So all the terminals of both the MOSFETs M1 and M2 are tied together. So this is my simplified version of this main circuit over here, right? Now what do we do is, the two nodes X and Y are tied together. So now what happens is M1 and M2 becomes in parallel. They are in parallel because all of their nodes are tied together. X and Y are the drain terminals. Gate terminal is connected to Vin of CM, that is also tied together. And your source terminal is the common only over here, right? So therefore they say, they share M1 and M2 are in parallel because they share all of their respective terminals. And therefore the circuit can be reduced to this equivalent circuit. Shown in the figure 31.1.3. So what happened over here? Okay, so since two resistors are in parallel we can write over here combined composite network will be M1 plus M2. And here we'll have register RSS as it is, in input applied to the gate terminal. And why does become RD by 2, anyone? In the equivalent circuit, why do we have RD by 2? Why not RD only? And of course, output is taken from the drain terminal. Anyone has any idea in this? It's very simple, in fact. Whenever register RD and this register RD are in parallel, so we know the parallel combination of same resistance will be half that value. So that's why over here we get RD divided by 2. I hope it is clear. Now what do we do is, now since your M1 and M2 are reduced to one composite device with twice the width, because now width is also increasing, right? Twice the width, bias current and transconductance. So all of them are increasing twice. So here, if you look into this terminal, source terminal, you will find instead of 1 upon GM, we'll find 1 upon twice GM. So now assuming that lambda is equal to 0 and gamma is equal to 0, that means you are ignoring the body effect. The common mode gain of the circuit is given by as follows. Now this becomes a normal common source amplifier with source degeneration. So what is the formula for that? Minus RD divided by 2 divided by 1 upon GM twice GM plus RSS. So here is my common mode voltage gain given by minus of RD divided by 2 divided by 1 upon GM, 1 upon twice GM plus RSS, where GM, small GM, will denote the transconductance of each of the MOSFETs M1 and M2. Okay, so what will happen is, in a symmetric circuit, overall we can say that the input common mode variations disturbed the bias point and they affect the small signal gain and also the output swing. Okay, so we have in short, we have derived with simplified manner the common mode voltage gain for this circuit, wherein we have applied a common mode input response. Any clarity required in this 31.1.10 equation? How do we got this? The, we have applied the formula for the common source amplifier with source degeneration. It's the same result only. Only thing is, you should remember that whenever M1 and M2 are in parallel, their widths will be increasing by twice. Their bias current will be increasing by twice and the transconductance also. So that's the clue over here. Okay, so now let's move on to the next part. Yeah, so quantitatively, we will analyze this differential pair very quickly. So let's say we assume a perfect symmetric circuit. Okay, over here, right? And you know, perfect symmetric circuit means what? ID1 will be equal to ID2, which will be equal to ISS by 2, and VX is equal to VY, which is given by VDD minus ID, RD into ISS by 2. Okay, so this we have already established before. So this equation 30.1.12 will signify that for a zero differential input, will give a zero differential output. That means if you give VX minus VY almost close to zero, your output, if the input is differential and zero, your output will also be zero, right? Because VX and VY are same over here. But the output common mode level is given by V out of CM, which is given by VDD minus RD into ISS divided by 2. Okay, so that's the clue we should remember. So let's now find out the equilibrium overdrive voltage of M1 and M2. What is overdrive voltage? VGS minus VTH, equilibrium value. So let's assume lambda is equal to 0. So ID expression can be written as half mu n C of W by L VGS minus VTH the whole square. Okay, now let's just assume that your M1 and M2 transistors will carry equal current ISS by 2. Therefore, each device will exhibit an overdrive of VGS minus VTH equilibrium value. Now, sorry for this. Now, if we write the expression of VGS minus VTH in terms of all other parameters, what do we get? ISS, actually it will come twice ISS divided by mu n C ox W by L. It should be twice ISS, I guess. Yeah, here it will be. We are saying it's carrying a current of ISS by 2. Let's say it's carrying a current of ISS by 2. So here it will be ISS by 2. Okay, so that 2 and 2 will get cancelled. And your overdrive voltage, equilibrium overdrive voltage for both the transistors, because they are symmetric, it will be VGS minus VTH equilibrium value will be equal to square root of ISS divided by mu n Cox W by L. Did you understand why 2 is not over here? Because ID is basically now ISS by 2. So 2 from left hand side and right hand side will get cancelled out and you get equation 30.1.14. So therefore, if you say that we have a greater tail current, if ISS is more or we have a smaller W by L ratio, it will result in a larger overdrive voltage. So I can say my VGS minus VTH will be larger if ISS is very large or W by L ratio is very small. Any of those cases. Now, to guarantee that your M1 and M2 operates in the saturation region, we can write VDS1 should be greater than VGS minus VTH. And what is VDS1? VD1 minus VS1. What is VGS1? VG1 minus VS1 minus VTH. Okay. Now VS1, VS1 gets cancelled because they are the same. And what is VD1? VD1 is nothing but VDD minus ID1 into RD. Correct. And what is VG1? VG1 is nothing but V in of CM. And this is VTH. So we can now say that your ID1, actually we are assuming that both M1 and M2 are carrying equal current, equal to ISS by 2. So we replace this ID1 by ISS by 2. So we have now a new equation, which is VDD minus RD into ISS by 2 should be greater than Vin of CM minus VTH. That's a very important equation. And we observe over here that a change in the Vin of CM, change in the input common mode level, cannot alter ID1 and ID2, leaving Vx and Vy undisturbed. That means the circuit is rejecting the input common mode variation because your Vx and Vy are not getting disturbed at all due to common mode signal. Okay, so and this equation, this condition shown in the equation 30.1.15 will ensure that your M1 and M2 operates guaranteed in the saturation region. Okay, so this completes the discussion on the qualitative analysis of the differential amplifier with common mode input response. Yeah, any doubts over here? Any clarity required?